The video you're about to watch was developed as a job aid to help you, the NWS rep, perform complex or infrequently performed tasks. This job aid was not meant to replace any directives, maintenance, or modification notes, or any other documented procedures. If there is a conflict between this job aid and any official documents, the documents will take precedent.
Technical proficiency in the field is critical to NWS staff being able to establish or relocate a cooperative observing site and maintain that equipment properly to guarantee data quality. This video will step you through the process of maintaining an 8-inch standard rain gauge. Policy and procedures related to the SRG can be found in NWS Manual 10-13-15, Cooperative Station Observations, Appendix A. This job aid will help you gain an understanding or refamiliarization with the following. Check that the gauge is level and how to perform gauge releveling is necessary. Perform visual inspection of the overflow can, measuring tube, and funnel for obvious leaks. Perform hydrostatic tests to ensure integrity of the overflow can and measuring tube. Check integrity and readability of the measuring sticks. Clean up and follow up with the observer before leaving.
Now we're ready to do field maintenance on the 8-inch rain gauge. You've just come out to the station. You've said hi to the observer, asked them if they had any questions. We're going to start with doing a visual check of the components of the rain gauge. First off, check to make sure if they've had any rain or that there's any water in the measuring tube, that you take the measurement first before you do anything else. That way, if you have to empty it, you could tell the observer how much rainfall was in it already. The thing you're going to do as part of your maintenance is you're going to check the state of the measuring sticks for the rain gauge to make sure that they're easy to read, they're not cracked or broken, and that the observer has at least one spare. Talk to the observer and find out if they're having any trouble reading it. This is important to make sure that you leave the observer with the best equipment possible to take as accurate a measurement as they can. We have the fiberglass funnel here, and what you're looking for are cracks, any potential cracks. You're also looking in here, well, I hate to say this, but birds sometimes like to perch on this and make a mess. So this may need cleaning, and this is a good time to do it. Sometimes you could just rinse it through with water. They've got a hose and a good nozzle on it. That's enough. Sometimes you may have to chip off some of the hardened excrement, but leave it clean. The other thing is the funnels get older, whether it's fiberglass or even the metal. They start getting a little bit pitted. And what happens is when you get light rainfall, the microscopic pits can hold water. And instead of the water draining down into the funnel and into the measuring tube, it could end up sticking to the side of the inside of the funnel. And what happens is you can end up getting evaporation on that precipitation before it ever gets into the measuring tube. So in a sense, you've lost precipitation. One way you can help to alleviate that problem is carry some car wax with you, whether it's hand wax or the spray-on. But just take some of that and put a nice little coating and buff it in here into the inside of the funnel. Next, I'll look at the measuring tube. This is a fairly new one in very good shape, but I'm gonna, again, if there's water in it, it's already performing what I would call a hydrostatic test. In other words, if there's no leaks, you look in the inside of the overflow can and there's no water in there, you can assume that it's not leaking. But if it's a plastic tube, or if it's one of the old brass tubes that may have a seam on it, you need to check for those things. It may be okay now, but you may be able to tell by a bulge or the start of a crack, even with this, and it may be something you may need to replace. Again, same thing. You're gonna look at the state of the overflow can. Look at the seams, look at the bottom, make sure it looks, you don't see any noticeable cracks or splits, anything like that. And then we're gonna do a hydrostatic test, again, just putting water in it and see if it leaks. Okay, what we're gonna do now is the hydrostatic test on the measuring tube. And sometimes you're at observing sites where they don't have a convenient water hose for you to run out to the gauge. So in this case, you may have to bring a bucket of water out with you. And I'm not going to necessarily fill the tube up all the way, but I did come within about an inch of the top of the tube. Now, typically what I'll do is take a paper towel and wipe off any of the excess water that might have spilled out of the tube. When I've done that, I will get another piece of paper, put it on the ground, and then I'll put the tube on that, and I'll go and complete the rest of the work on the stand at the gauge. While that, I'll come back and check and see if anything's leaked out. That way you can tell whether or not you have any cracks. We finished our hydrostatic check, and we found no leaks in either the measuring tube or in the overflow can, so we're ready to put the gauge back together. So again, we've checked the level. We put the measuring tube back in, and we've installed the funnel back on. And we're going to do one last check for a level, and it's right on the money. So the gauge is good. It's ready to go. One other thing you're going to check before you leave is check around the base of the gauge itself. Look for weeds, long grass. Hopefully you have a pair of clippers in with your equipment, or you can borrow the observers. Clean up around the gauge. Leave it better than you found it. The other thing before you leave, talk to the observer. Make sure that they don't have any questions. If you're in snow country, it's always a good time to go over snow observation techniques. Ask the observer if they put the snowboard in a different place. If they have any questions about taking their snow measurements. While you're here and with the observer making your annual trip, this is the time to get it all done. Don't be in a hurry. Don't show the observer that you're in a big hurry to leave. But don't overstay your welcome either. Do what's appropriate, but make your visit count.
Having completed this video job aid on the 8-inch standard rain gauge, you should now be familiar with the equipment and the standard maintenance and visitation practices. Again, official policy and maintenance procedures can be found in the NWS Manual 10.13.15, Appendix A. Siting standards for precipitation gauges can be found in NWS 10.13.02, Section 3.2.
One last reminder, as the SRG is ground zero for most co-op stations, you'll want to double check the equipment layout and obstructions on the B-44 and update them as necessary.